Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieku, and today I'm gonna be talking about a nightmare. I'm gonna be talking about a menace that haunts our dreams as artists in general. And I'm talking about AI. Everybody knows that AI is gonna steal your wife, your husband, your kids, your job, everything that you ever loved, it's gone. But there's this handful of people who actually believe, can you imagine that? Who actually believe that AI is gonna benefit us. So recently I was presented with this little piece of software which is called Project Dream. Now, why on earth did this pagan sorcery came on RenderRam table? Well, because it's linked to 3ds Max, that's why. So this is Project Dream. I think you can maybe find it a little bit familiar to this other piece of software, which is called Scene Manager. So Scene Manager and Project Dream are made by the same company, but all that is cute and fluffy, etc. But let's see how this thing actually performs. So when you fire up Project Dream, one of the first things that you need to know is that you have these three tabs here, or these three buttons. So one is Prompt, Viewport, and Image. Prompt is pretty much self-explanatory. You have the prompt area here, you just write whatever you want, click on the dream button, and it's gonna just generate the images. But if you go to the viewport section, now in the viewport section you have this part, and here you can choose all your instances of Max and just pick which one you're working on. So I have this instance of Max, which is this one here. So it can directly grab whatever is in your viewport. So look at this. If I create another box here, let's say here, and I go to my Project Dream, and I just click the fetch button, it's gonna update it there. So let's start messing about with some prompts. Kids room, wooden floors, white walls, toys on the floor, table lamp, sunny day, sunny outside, white window, whatever. Now let me click on the dream button. Now, while this is generating, each image that you generate, it takes about 30-ish seconds to create. For this example, if you scroll a little bit down, I've set it to create 4 images at once. So under the images section, you can choose 1, 2, 3, or 4 images to be created at once. It's a similar approach to Midjourney, which also creates 4 images. So this will take roughly around 2-ish minutes, sometimes less, sometimes more, but 2 minutes is a ballpark. And while this generates, let me just cover this another important thing, which is the creativity slider here. So yeah, by the way, you can just see like snippets of previews which are going to be generated here. Also, you can see that 1 out of 4 images is currently being generated. So the creativity slider, the higher you go, the AI has more freedom to do whatever it wants with your screenshot from your Max. The lower you go, it's gonna directly take whatever the screenshot makes and it's gonna try to make an image based of that. So basically, if you set the creativity slider to like 10%, it's gonna look the same as your screenshot, but a little bit different. So our 4 generations are done. Let's see what is created. So we got this image, then we got this, this, this. Now, my prompt is very basic. The more you invest words in your prompt, the more detailed it's gonna get. Keep in mind, my scene was practically made out of boxes, so the input is very, very rough. But again, the results that we got are these. Now, is this a tool that's gonna create final images for you? Will you send this to a client? Hell no. This is an inspirational tool. So what is the purpose of Project Dream? Whatever you're working on, this thing will generate suggestions for you and you will get a better idea on what kind of mood do you like. You can even get a much clearer picture on like which way to drive your creativity with your image. And that's it. This is literally like a, like an AI client who actually knows what he likes, and he's sitting right next to you and he's just giving out suggestions and you actually pick which one you like. But I've actually put this to a test, to a practical use, just so that it's not, like me showing how the program works. So I needed to create an actual kids room for my project. So this is the image that I created with Project Dream. There are various elements that helped me kind of guide how I want my image to look like. One of the details that it helped me is the idea for the arch, the idea for the lighting on how soft the lighting is, the lighting idea that, there is this kind of like imaginable door here, which, shines the light inside. Those are some of the things that Project Dream helped me with. Oh, the rug, for example. And another cool thing is it really thinks about the composition of the image. So for example, these little boxes here on the floor, that's the AI idea. And I really liked it. And here I can actually show you how I started this whole thing. So I started with this image and it just just generated that. So I had my bed already made, set up, etc. As you can see, for the mattress, I literally placed a box inside. So the more I was generating, look, here it kind of gave me the idea of the round rug. So here I updated my max preview with a round rug because I liked the idea. And I wanted to have some like nightstands or whatever, you know, like next to it just to fill the image. And the whole, you know, generation journey started. Here I decided to put light blue walls. And then the arch idea actually sparked here. You can see how it created the arch. And I like that. So the more I was developing things, you know, I was designing it like before I even started doing a, you know, a concrete project, and it all led me to this image, and I was super happy about it, and my client was happy about it, which is the most important thing. So Project Dream is an idea generator, and that's a very cool thing about it. Now let's go into some tiny technicalities. Here we have the simple input, and you can choose to have a detailed input. So what is the difference? Simple input is made if you are using scene like this, which is just, you know, made out of the boxes. But if you go to the detail input, I can use this image and it's gonna take all the little details. So the detail input is literally designed if you have like the majority of the scene set up and you just need to play with the lighting or whatever, and it's gonna pay attention to all those little details that you have in your scene. So this is, you can guess once, it's Evermotion Arc Exteriors Volume 35, and this is how it looks. So this is the Evermotion scene, and you can check the whole Arc Exteriors Volume 35 collection. You have tons of buildings, tons of everything. I think it's pretty cool because you get all those assets inside. I think it's dope. Anyhow, let's get back to our scene. So to capture this scene from the viewport, you just need to click on your different max here and just click fetch, and it's gonna create a preview here. So I created a couple of images, but there are some differences to these images. So all of these are created with the detailed input. If you go to the top here, you can pick which type of AI model would you like to use. So you have the lush exterior, exterior, interior, which I used in my kid's bedroom. You have the artistic, you have the flexible. So let's see what are some of the key differences. So this one is made with flexible. So I got this, and this. Looks pretty nice. Then I went to the lush exterior. So the lush exterior looks a little bit different. Like you can feel it's a different style. You have these nice highlights everywhere. It just looks lush. And yeah, I got this image. So why this? Because I wrote leaves at the end. So it figured out that I might want to have a street that's filled with leaves. And then if we move to the next one, it's artistic. Artistic pretty much looks artistic. But the cool thing is, if you like any of these images, you can actually click this make public button, and everybody can see that, and people can see what you did, what prompts you used, etc. You can even click here if you like the image or not. This will help the developers to kind of develop more the whole model for generation. But the main thing, when I said make public, if you go to the showcase here, you can actually see what other people have generated, and you can see the previous versions of it, etc. So for example, if I click on this image, you have the little comparison button. Look, you can even see the variations that people used. Here you can see what model was used, so lush exterior. You can see all the tiny little details, but look at this. If you go to comparison, you can check out from max viewport to the final image how it looked like. So cool thing is, if for example you like this image and you like how it looks like, you can click on the variations button and it's gonna give you four different variations of that same image. Also here on the right, you have this little plus button which creates a new project. That's how I got these two. And you have just the playground. If you click on the playground, here you can just see the random stuff that you generate. It's all gonna be tossed like in one bucket. Now, how does the logic of prompting work? Well, the more precise you are, the better it's gonna look like. Again, you need to kind of get into the feeling of what, you know, how intensive some sliders are, etc. If you want to go advanced, you can even click here. You see now it's in the simple mode. If you go to the advanced mode, you're gonna get a couple of more features here. So for example, with every image, you can actually upload a reference image. So the AI is gonna follow all the colors, compositions, etc. You can even click or unclick magic salt. Magic salt is a very interesting button. So if you add magic salt, any prompt that you make, the AI is gonna rephrase it better so that you get a better result. If you turn off magic salt, it's gonna use your prompt directly as it is. And yeah, this is Project Dream. I had a blast, to be honest with it, because for example, I'm more of a technical artist, like technical person rather than artistic person. So, you know, I always kind of struggle with art, if we can call it like that. But this is a really cool thing to have, you know, like I can have this like my own private interior, exterior, stylist, whatever, which can help me in my creations. But the whole thing cannot just end here.
There is a giveaway. So let's shoot out some gifts.
So there will be three prizes or three winners who are gonna win 1 month of Project Dream Pro license. And there are gonna be three ways how you can win it. So whoever sends an email the fastest to my email, renderram.cgi@gmail.com, wins 1 month Project Dream. Second, again, my ugly face is hidden in the video somewhere. Whoever finds it first, write in the comments where it is, and you're gonna win 1 month pro license of Project Dream. Last time, you guys found it in like 20 minutes, and I thought it's gonna be very hard. It wasn't. And the third license is actually split among 50 of you. So what does that mean? So whenever you register to polls and you wanna try out Project Dream, you're gonna get a trial license. But trial is actually limited because you have watermarks, you can't upscale, and you can't do variations. But if you use this code on polls webpage, you can actually get 2 weeks of pro license, full pro, no limitations, but it's gonna only go to 50 of you. So hurry up to Pool's website. So when you open the Pool's website, go to your profile and you have gift codes quickly. Type that code here and you're gonna get your 14 days of pro license of Project Dream. But there is a but here. On the 3rd of January, one of these 52-week pro licenses is rigged. So one of them, or one of 50 of you, your license is gonna be transformed to 1 month full Project Dream Pro license. How? Who? God knows, but one of you is gonna become a pro. Again, please check the description of this video for all the details on the giveaway, when it starts, when it ends, etc. blah blah blah. And that's it for today, guys. I wanna thank Pools for sponsoring this video. I wanna thank Evermotion for sponsoring this video and giving us this beautiful Arc Exteriors Volume 35 scene. See you in the next video. Bye. Just a quick note, this contest is not sponsored by YouTube. I'm solely responsible for the contest and delivering the prizes to winners.